The forest, an undisturbed habitat? That was the case in the past, but today many forests don't have room for wild animals anymore. Monotonous tree plantations planted for quick money. Virgin forests have been turned into modern enterprises. They exist to provide raw materials for building, fuel, furniture and paper. Powerful machines called harvesters are being used more and more. Logging, sawing and loading go on all year round. There's no peace and quiet in this forest. That makes it all the more surprising that such a sensitive species as the black stork has returned here on its own accord. From the expert's perspective, it's a sensation. Such a large, colourful bird as the black stork is returning to German forests, and hardly anybody has noticed. The experts were faced with a mystery for a long time. Black storks first started breeding again in northern Rhineland-Palatinate in the early 1980s. They liked the region's big, quiet forests. Like this old beechwood, where no timber has been cut for a long time. The old trees are guarding a secret that's hard to spot. For some years now, black storks have been returning here, living undisturbed and unmolested. Nobody knows exactly when they came back. Do they have young already? And there's the answer. A young bird is carefully walking through the forest as if it had left its nest for the first time. Black storks are masters of disguise. The large nest, which measures around 2 meters in diameter and is 50 centimeters high, lies hidden in a tree. Black storks aren't strangers to this forest. More than 100 years ago, their ancestors flew over the forests of the Eifel, Hunsrück and Westerwald. At the time, their breeding territory reached far into Central Europe. One of the naturalists of the time, Prince Maximilian of Wied, who lived in Neuwied on the Rhine, observed the black storks. In his sketches dating from 1841, he commented that he'd encountered these beautiful birds from time to time on hunts. The black storks didn't come to the lakes of the Westerwald, the princely family's hunting grounds, every year. Even at that time, they were a rare sight. Ruthless persecution of the black storks probably began in around 1850. They had a bad reputation as fishing pests. The shy birds retreated further and further east. No wonder that hardly anyone in Germany still knows about black storks. In contrast to its relative, the popular white stork. Unlike black storks, white storks seek out the company of humans. They build their nests in villages and towns, on the roofs of houses and churches. They nest wherever they find a suitable place. even on chimneys and towers. Sometimes even in unusual and dangerous spots, as long as people leave them to it. Even though white storks are very popular in Germany, they too almost died out as a result of worsening living conditions. Large-scale protection programs have managed to preserve the white storks in some parts of Germany. The fact that black storks are living and breeding again in German forests is a gift of nature. They came back all alone without any human help. Experts still speculate about the reasons they've returned. What's certain is that these shy birds only nest where they have quiet and suitable living conditions. Like here in the forest of the black storks. It's March in the forest of the black storks. In the uplands between Cologne and Frankfurt, winter still has a firm grip on the world. High up in a beech tree, the raven is sitting on its nest, warming its young. The forest looks dull and lifeless. Rain and snow showers alternate. It's a wet, cold March, typical of this region. Soon the black storks will return from their warm winter quarters to breed here. But one of them has arrived already, as the fresh droppings around the nest show. The black stork flies to his nest several times a day. He is waiting for his partner. But, like every year, she'll arrive 2 to 3 weeks later than him. It's quite common for black stork partners to arrive separately at their nesting site. After the dull, wet weeks, better weather is finally announcing itself. The winter will soon come to an end. The black stork is still waiting for his partner to return. Patiently, almost motionless, he spends hours standing on the nest. Finally, the forest of the black storks is lit up by the spring sunlight. His neighbour, the lesser-spotted woodpecker, is already hard at work building the nursery for this year's young. Red deer are finding the first fresh food after the meagre winter fare on the forest meadow. In the neighbouring forest, the raven pair are inspecting the airspace over their breeding spot. Finally, the partner he's been waiting for so long has arrived. The two storks greet each other extravagantly. Immediately after the female's arrival, the birds begin the mating ritual. But the winter isn't over yet. The biological clock is now ticking for the two black storks because they've only got a narrow window in which they can raise their young. In the remoteness of the old beech forest, the two can focus completely on their upcoming jobs. At least it seems that way. The weather still has some surprises in store. It can happen that it starts snowing out of the blue. Typical April weather. Sometimes it rains, sometimes it snows. Then it's gloriously sunny again. The black storks aren't bothered. As soon as the weather has calmed down again, they continue their courtship. Suddenly, a third stork shows up in their breeding spot. It's not just the juvenile birds from last year and the year before who are on their way to their summer territories. Unpaired individuals are looking for a mate and their own breeding spot. The two storks immediately interrupt their courtship. They have to be on their guard. Both storks fly off to fend off the interloper together. As soon as the nest's owners are out of the way, another forest inhabitant seizes the moment to visit the stork's nest. The raven, who already has hungry young to look after, is inspecting the stork's nest. But he doesn't find what he's looking for. There aren't any eggs in the nest yet. That's bad luck for the raven, and good luck for the storks. On their return, the two have no idea they had an unwelcome guest. The big birds are in wedding mood. They are displaying their white ventral feathers, arranged like fans. But suddenly, their behavior changes. Something has caught their attention. The third stork has landed not far from their nest. The pair continue their courtship unperturbed. They go even further. One of the birds lies down demonstratively in the middle of the nest, showing who's the boss. The intruder doesn't stand a chance. One of the storks watches the rival ceaselessly. The pair still look fairly relaxed. They don't look nervous at all. Then something incredible happens. The intruder attacks the nest. At the last minute, the two storks manage to fend him off. Immediately, they're absolutely alert. The rival waits for his next opportunity to strike. Agitated, the pair demonstrate that they won't tolerate a stranger near them. This act doesn't have anything to do with family planning. It's meant to show other storks that they're together and that the nest is off limits to others. Will the intruder get the message? Above the stork's forest, the spring sun is shining. But for many forest animals, food is still scarce. The jay is glad to fall back on his stores as long as he can find them. And find them before someone else does, like the raven. The approaching spring is audible now too. The great spotted woodpeckers are singing and drumming. The chaffinches are trying to out-sing each other. The black storks are using the rising midday thermals to circle above their forest territory together. This kind of synchronized flying is also a sign of their pairing. But even majestic birds like black storks can experience some unpleasant surprises up in the air. Only through some fast manoeuvring can the stork escape the attack by the bird of prey. That puts an early end to their outing. The attacked bird quickly returns to the nest. Soon the time has come for the first stork egg. Overnight, the forest of the black storks has turned green. The stork's nest has its first eggs, strictly guarded by one of the parents. Usually, a clutch consists of 3 to 4 eggs. The young hatch after a bit more than a month. The blackbird in the neighboring tree has been sitting on her eggs for several days now. By the end of April, the old beech forest has spread out almost its entire canopy, providing protection and shade for the stork's nest. For hours, the guardian has been waiting to be relieved, but the calls remain unanswered. The stork is anxiously listening. The rival stork is circling above the nest again. Will her partner return to the nest in time? Too late. The intruder launches an attack straight away. He flies around the nest in a big circle and attacks. But the parent successfully defends the nest and the clutch. The attacker leaves the forest. It's all the more surprising that the parent chooses this moment to leave the nest. Now the eggs have no protection from attackers. It's risky behaviour that will have consequences. It's the end of May. Normally, black stork chicks should be sticking up their heads to beg for food. But not this year. The pair of storks lost their clutch. Instead, the male is mating with his partner again. Even though they're behind schedule, the couple begin all over again. One week later, things are quiet again in the forest of the black storks. Usually, only one of the birds is on the nest, but from time to time they keep each other company. There are some loving gestures, like this caressing the head. But it could be that it's not a sign of affection, but rather a matter of hygiene. The breeding pair take a break from time to time. What's noticeable is that they're now keeping their nest meticulously clean. They don't have to mark it with droppings anymore as a sign that it's occupied, as they had to when they arrived in spring. The eggs are turned regularly to keep them at a constant temperature all round. Now the black storks need absolute peace and quiet. Any other interruption would put an end to this year's breeding season. There's no third chance. There's no time. But everything remains quiet in the forest of the black storks. One of the storks can calmly go and look for food, while the other guards the nest. It's early summer, one of the nicest seasons in the forest. Finally, the black storks have the young they've been waiting for. They're guarded around the clock. One of the parents is always at the nest. A new chapter is beginning for the parents. Now they have to supply their young with food too. They often have to fly long distances to find enough. They use a special flying strategy to do that. They spiral up into the sky above their breeding spot. They end this climb with a few strong flaps of the wings and then fly towards their destination at great heights. This old remote mill stream is ideal. Here the black storks can look for food in peace and quiet. They will catch small fish, newts and water insects. In short, everything the stream has to offer. Its small prey the young can swallow easily. These feeding grounds are popular with the competition too. Rivals are eyed with suspicion. Once the air is cleared, the hunt can finally begin. There's not much time. The hungry young storks are waiting in the nest. Summer is now in full swing in the forest of the black storks. The two shaggy young birds are around 50 days old. They're just losing the last white feathers of their infant plumage. The parents aren't constantly on the nest anymore. They're guarding their young from a certain distance. The young birds aren't yet capable of protecting themselves from enemies. It looks as if the parents have left their young unprotected, but that's misleading. The nest is still under their constant surveillance. The parent only left the forest when it was clear the other was watching the chicks. A change in the weather is making itself felt. Strong winds are gusting through the forest. The wind is perfect for the young black storks. They're using it to do their first flight exercises. Every gust helps them train their muscles for the first departure. The parents still bring them food 4 to 5 times a day. But the parent birds only stay on the nest long enough to bring up the food. At this age, the young start fighting for food more and more. They're developing aggressive food envy. It's a sign they're growing up. It's hot. The sun is burning mercilessly over the forest. It hasn't rained in weeks. The water level has fallen significantly in the mill stream. Some animals manage to find a bite or two in the mud, such as this green sandpiper. Others, on the other hand, catch their prey exclusively in the water, such as this kingfisher. A journey of discovery in the mud. It's a great experience for the little mallards. If it weren't for the heat, making life difficult. The black stork parents just have to feed their young for a few more days. But that job is getting harder and harder. Black storks like to fish by sight, as long as the water is clean and clear. But now they have to fish in muddy waters, and they're coming up empty more and more often. And then there's this paralyzing heat. Then finally, the first drops of rain start to fall. The young birds hardly notice the cool, wet rain. Under the leafy canopy of the big beech, they are as protected as if they were under an umbrella. The shower was much too short. Above the forest of the black storks, the rain has only brought little refreshment. It's not long before the sun has come out again. The heat marathon continues. Finally, visibility is clear again. Now the black stork has to hurry. The young are longingly awaiting their meal. By the end of August, the young should have left the nest, but there are always exceptions. When the storks return too late from their winter quarters, or, as here, when the breeding was interrupted. It's rare now for the parents to fly directly to the nest to feed the young. This behaviour is designed to encourage the young to start looking for food independently as quickly as possible. The powerful begging of the almost adult young is making it very difficult for the parent to bring up the food. It also has to watch out for the beak attacks of its offspring. As soon as its crop is empty, the parent leaves the nest and the forest. Water is still scarce in the old mill stream. The storm shower hasn't brought any noticeable improvement. The heat remains insufferable. Those who can, take a refreshing bath. It's important for all of the birds to look after their feathers well. The black storks are coming here more often than usual, even though they're not looking for food. The old mill stream is a popular meeting place, and not just among storks. This can lead to confrontations when the best spots are at stake, especially when they're already occupied. He wasn't expecting that. The aggressive grey heron almost knocked him out of the tree. This black stork has had an extensive bath. It doesn't take long for the feathers to dry in these temperatures. It's important to impregnate the feathers again after the wash. To do that, the bird uses a fatty secretion from its preen gland and distributes it all over the plumage. Black storks take a lot of time looking after their bodies. They can only go about their business untroubled where they have absolute peace and quiet. Meanwhile, the two young storks are preparing for their first excursion. The bolder of the two is already standing quite securely on the swaying branch. This one, on the other hand, isn't brave enough yet. He watches his sibling from the nest. He bravely masters the balancing act, which isn't without its dangers. The younger stork prefers to test his flying skills from the nest. Better safe than sorry. The balancing act is working, but he hasn't found the right place to take off from. The tension is passed on to the sibling. Then, after much hesitation, the crucial moment is finally here. For the first time in his life, the young stork is leaving the nest and flying, albeit for just a few seconds. Now, at the end of the breeding season, the parent birds will start molting. They'll get a new coat of feathers. Finally, they have time to rest and relax. But soon, they'll have to leave their territory again and start their long journey to the warm south. Sometimes the hormones play up. One of the male black storks is getting spring fever in the middle of summer. He is pursuing a female with clear intentions. It's somewhat unusual behaviour, since the departure for the winter quarters is coming closer. Maybe this male lost his partner. There is news in the forest of the black storks. One of the two young has landed on the forest floor for the first time. The more cowardly one hasn't plucked up the courage yet. The braver sibling is exploring the forest with curiosity. Up until now, he's only had a bird's eye view. Then finally, the younger black stork decides to attempt flying for the first time. Just to land back in the nest again a short while later. It's the big step into independence. Their flying skills are becoming more and more routine. It won't be long now before the two young birds will be flying through the forest in which they were hatched together. Then they will start looking for their own food too. But until they leave the nest for good, their parents will continue to look after them. That happens exclusively in the nest. This is the only place to which the parents bring food. The young storks have grown and are as big as their parents. They can only be distinguished by the lack of red on the beak and legs. Over the next few days, the parents will reduce their food even more. The days when the parents stay close to the nest are over. They are preparing to leave their breeding grounds again. The old mill stream has been the ideal meeting place for the black storks for some time now. They've come here from far away to spend the last few days here before the Great Migration. Now it's not clear anymore which two birds are the breeding pair here and which black storks are just stopping in on their way south. But that's not the case when the storks are ringed. Then it's even possible to get extensive information about every single bird. The black stork, which is now three, was ringed with his three siblings in a nest in Mecklenburg-Vorpommern, a good 600 kilometres from the old mill stream as the stork flies. And there's more. During the return from the winter quarters, it flew over a small town in Spain in his second year. A bird watcher informed the relevant authorities. Such data are collected and exchanged on an international level through ringing programs. Gathering places like this one at the old mill stream are unfortunately rare in densely populated Germany. The landowners and tenants who leave such oases untouched deserve praise. These images prove that land use and species protection can work together. The same is also true of forestry. The two young birds don't know yet that this will be their last day in the forest of the black storks. They are becoming more and more secure in the branches and more skilled in the air. The second young bird is now a good flyer, although somewhat hesitant. Shy, large birds like black storks can only live in quiet landscapes such as this old beech forest. Young birds in particular need a tranquil area during this phase of their lives, to gather important experiences. They are extremely shy and jumpy, and react very sensitively to the smallest incidents. They're exploring the forest floor together for the first time. They want to be close to each other in this unknown terrain. Everything new is examined with curiosity. Maybe it's edible. But careful. There's trouble. The wild boars are known to the two young storks. But this time, they're meeting them down at ground level, and not from the safety of their nest. He's not so brave anymore. This one too thinks the situation's too dangerous. They quickly decide to retreat. A little while later, they meet again. On the boggy forest meadow, they feel safe from the grunting creatures. They're standing on wet ground for the first time. There must be a snack here somewhere. Again, they can hear disquieting noises. But this time, their urge to explore is stronger than their fear. They can't place the banging. Another threatening situation. They don't know it, but the cause is harmless. They stand there perplexed, not knowing what to do. Should they go back to the forest? No. This time, the young black storks decide not to fly back to the safety of their nest. Several times they fly elegantly through the old beech forest in which they were born and grew up. They glide over the small forest clearing where they were just standing. Then finally, after one last lap of honour, they leave their nursery for good. The young birds have set off on their long migration to the warm south. Soon the time will come for the adult black storks to follow them. This is their last chance to rest and find their strength before they set off together. Now they are setting off on their long journey to their winter quarters. Twice a year, these birds fly up to 5,000 kilometers. Most of them travel all the way to Africa. It's a dangerous journey. Weather, enemies and hunters always claim their share. In the forest of the black storks, it's quiet now. The big nest will remain uninhabited for the next 6 months. The black storks don't know the autumn and winter forest. They will only return in spring and move back into their old nests. One day, who knows, every child in Germany will be as familiar with black storks as with white ones. If German forests are managed with more care for nature in the future, other animals will surely return to the forest of the black storks too.